Yes, today we gather here is to talk about our products. So, and there are so many benefits in our products. So today we are going to break it down into small little bite size for you. So we are going to talk about the benefit of calcium. So then, do you know what is calcium is all about? Do we all know, right? Calcium, of course, we all know is an essential mineral for life, right? So without calcium, so our life will be in danger. So it's very, very crucial mineral for life. And it's the most abundant mineral in our body. So this is also something that we all know about it, right? So it's a vital for our bone health. So that's why calcium is very important. That is also the reason why all mammals have to consume milk in order for us to grow from baby to adulthood. So that's why we all know that bone health is very important so that we can stay healthy, we can grow tall, and we also don't have any other problem. So then we want to talk a little bit more about the facts of calcium for human, right? So how many of you know the facts? So it's a fun fact that we are going to talk about, right? So human needs calcium to build and maintain strong bones. So this is what I just mentioned early. But do you know 99% of the body's calcium is in the bones and teeth? It's in our teeth. That's why you see most of us have more than 30 pieces of teeth, right? So everyone is made up of calcium. So as our nail, our hair. So, and the other fact is, it is necessary for bone health. Calcium is necessary for bone health, cardiovascular and muscle function, and our nervous system signaling also, right? So most people may know that calcium is good for bones. So, but there are also the facts for the others function in our organ. We lost calcium to our nail, hair, skin, and also sweat and urine. So we all know all these facts. So maybe today is something that you learn. So our body cannot produce calcium. Do you know that? So our bodies can't produce calcium. So these are the facts. And where is all this calcium come from? So that's why you have to pay attention. So the next thing is we are going to talk about the, just give me a minute. Okay, so if we don't consume enough calcium that our body needs, then it will withdraw from our bones. Okay, and you can see in this picture. So the bones will eventually cause what they call it, osteoporosis, fracture, and things like that. So in short term, we cannot cope with it. But if it's happened too often, then our bones get weak and become more prone to breaking. Like I said, osteoporosis and blister bone disease. So these are the diseases that we rarely hear. So too many of us fall short of getting the right amount of calcium each day to help prevent bones loss. Low bone density and also broken bones. That's why you can see the first one is a very high density bone. If we have lost over the year or we don't have enough intake, so it can speed up the bone's density. That's why eventually when we grow old, our bones can be the last one, very hollow. Very hollow, that's why it's very easily prone to fracture bones and also broken bones. So these are the facts that we need to know. And why we need calcium. So do you all know why we need calcium? So let's take a look. Of course, the first thing is bone health, right? Bone health, like calcium, is essential for the development, growth, and maintenance of our bones. So like we already say, around 99% of the calcium in our human body is in the bone and teeth, our tooth, right? Calcium is essential for the development of growth and maintain of our bone. So like our children's grow, calcium contribute to the development of their bones. So that's why bones health is very, very important. But when a person stops growing, what does it mean stop growing? It means we become adulthood, so we stop growing. So calcium continues to help maintain the bones and slow down bone density loss, so which is natural part of the aging process. So, and also, of course, like female who have always experienced, like female who already experienced like menopause can lose bone density at a higher rate, faster. It grows lost faster than a man or a younger person. They have a higher risk of developing osteoporosis. So this is something that we need to pay attention if your customer is like an older woman. So this is something that they have to prevent and prepare for. And of course, when we don't have enough, then doctor may have to recommend some calcium supplement. So of course, that can lead to many other issue. All right. So, okay. Then the next thing, calcium will help our body is the muscle, our muscle contraction. So I don't think many of us know that actually calcium also work in our muscle contraction. So the calcium help regulate our muscle contraction. And when a nerve stimulate a muscle, the body release calcium. So the calcium help to protect in the muscle, carry out to work on the contraction. So that's why everything is something like a lubrication. It helps us to lubrications to the muscle. So that's why when you have enough calcium, it works much better. So it pumps the calcium out of your muscle, out of the muscle, and the muscle will relax. Okay, so this is something that calcium will help in our body also. Then the other things that the calcium will help is the cardiovascular system. Calcium play a key role in blood clotting. So we all know that when we have heart disease, mainly because of blood clot. So the process of clotting is complex and has a number of steps. So it's not like one; it happens in one day. This involves a range of chemical, including calcium. So calcium is play an important part in helping to unclog our blood vessel. So calcium roles in muscle function, maintaining the actions of the heart muscle. So heart also got muscle. Huh? So that's why calcium can relax and smooth the muscle so that the surround blood vessel can be relaxed. So various studies has indicated that a possible link between high consumption of calcium and lower blood pressure. Okay, so this is some research that already shows that if you have sufficient calcium, it can actually help to lower blood pressure. Right, amazing, right? So next, we are going into the calcium deficiency. What happens if we don't have enough calcium? So if a person with a calcium deficiency for a long period, our body will take calcium from our bones, because it's just how you heard, calcium work in various part of our body. So if we don't have enough, then it will draw from our bones, our teeth, then our bones will get weaker and become more prone to breaking, osteoporosis, and brittle bone disease, as I already mentioned. So as our tooth can be also decay, right? So that's why we get older, then we tend to have decay tooth or also our gum, right? So this is something. And the other one is also, when you don't have enough calcium, it can cause cataract. Okay, so calcium have long been known to play a role in cataract formation. So it is essential for various lens fiber cell processes. So this including differentiation. So our eyes have to differentiate light, darkness, color, brightness, and things like that. So calcium is the critical to the clarity of our lens. And abnormal calcium content correlated with the opacity in cataract human lenses. So that's why it's very crucial to have enough calcium. So muscle tension, I already mentioned just now, it can cause muscle ache or cramp or even spasm. So pain in the thigh, arms when walking or moving if we don't have enough calcium. So there are many, many causes to our body. And the other thing also, if don't have enough calcium, it can cause indigestion. Calcium is absorbed into our human small intestine by two general mechanisms. Like it will be called transcellular active transport process. So it's located in the large and the the other one is called duodenum upper intestine, the small intestine and the upper intestine in the layman terms. So in this passive process, it functions throughout the length of our intestine. So that's why you know this our length of intestine is very long, right? So when this process is not being properly processed, that's why it causes indigestion also. And I also mentioned it also can cause high blood pressure, right? Just now we already talked about it. Or artery, hardening of the artery. So this is very dangerous to our heart health. And of course, our nail and skin is mainly come from calcium. So the skin can become dry, nail can become easily blister, or even our hair can be very coarse. And it can cause PMS syndrome. So most women know that. And it can also cause insomnia. So this is very, very good facts that we need to know. So not only many other things, but calcium alone can cause so many discomfort and also lead to future diseases, right? What else? The lifestyle that can cause calcium loss, right? Why we lost calcium? So these are the lifestyle. Maybe we consume high salt diet. A lot of people like to eat very high salt diet. Okay, maybe eating too much of salt will increase the risk of high blood pressure also, and it also leads to the loss of our calcium. So meat lover, so we like to eat meat, but not balancing with our protein. So eating too much of meat will also lead to excessive or total dietary loss of protein. So which will increase the loss of urinary calcium. All right. So it's like everywhere also have calcium, not only in our bones. So insufficient fruit intakes, like we don't have balanced nutrients. Fruits are rich in potassium, so which help to reduce urinary calcium emission. So vitamin C in fruits is also one of the factors that promote calcium absorption. So when you have sufficient vitamin C in your body, so then the absorption can be better to build a stronger calcium base. Of course, coffee made with cocoa beans is not only a good source of potassium, but also a source of oxalic acid and caffeine. So this will help to increase calcium and reduce calcium loss also. The other things also, carbonated drinks. So if we have a lot of carbonated drinks, of course, we all know that it will very fast affected the bone's absorption, which has a side effect on the bone's growth. So that's why if you heard it today, maybe we have to reduce carbonated drinks ourselves and also to our children. So this is some of the calcium deficiency syndrome. Okay, but what is also good to build calcium? Like vitamin D, right? Vitamin D is also essential for bones health. Kay, can you change to next slide? All right, so vitamin D is also essential for bones health. So it's allowed the intestine to stimulate and absorb calcium. We all know that if we go under the sun, it will help us to build our bones, to build and to absorb and to maintain more calcium. So vitamin D is also come from sun. It can help to stimulate our intestine. So vitamin D also come from fish oil. So the daily product, and it's also, like I say already, exposure to the sun. So in adult, vitamin D deficiency, we mentioned, like osteoporosis and all these things, is result in poor bone density and muscular weakening. So this is very important. But for children, it can cause risk, which lead to several bow leg. You know, the children can have the leg, like, you know, grow inward. So the appears, that kind of appearance. So that is due to the softening of the bone. So the bone density is not strong enough. So this also something that if you see a children's walking like inward, we have to pay attention to that also. Okay, let's move on to talk about what is calcium rich food. So just now in the video, we heard a lot about that, right? So I don't know how much you have heard that. So let's move into see, let's say from dietary product, dairy products. So let's say from dairy product, milk, we all know that milk has a great source of calcium, which is well absorbed by our body. So for instance, like 1 cup of milk can provide 24 to about 25% of the daily value for this mineral. So that is like, it's only quarter of it, so 1 cup of milk. So, but also cheese. Most cheese are excellent source of calcium. Like Parmesan cheese, I think this is very common and you can easily get it in Malaysia. So Parmesan cheese packed 19% of the daily value of calcium. So yogurt is also one of the best source of calcium. It provides up to 34% of daily value in 1 cup, equal to about 245 grams. And it's also good source of protein and other nutrients. So you can see here, if you take milk, you have to take cheese. Just now in the video, it says that you consume 1 cup of milk plus 2 slices of concentrate cheese and plus substantial amounts of nuts. Then only you may have enough of one daily calcium value that required.